control war. So if you come a war and you know come flat out, most
You're going
likely
yeah, man.
you're going to
You're gonna
lose.
lose.
You see it?
Yeah.
So we lose the war and we come here come slave. And then now we are going to say to the man them who beat we for pay
We give you
we
your money. We
pay
help
we.
we. We put you back on the standard to fight them again.
No, they're not going to do
That sound
that.
away.
Yeah,
That
they're
sound
not going to do
away.
that. What them could have done now is put a noose around my neck and proceed with a hanging, because right now them still have the power to proceed with that hanging.
You mean with our groups like that international mass we a man call them IMF people
Oh,
them kind of groups there.
monetary fund.
Yeah, not funny though, you know.
No,
Not no funny about that.
monetary fund.
So really I suggest to the ones I want to listen though, you know, is that alternative ways of thinking. Just like how them creating these what them call alternative sexual lifestyles, see? I must begin to think in an alternative way. An alternative way is about just thinking about our blackness. Because the tradition has always been not to think about our blackness. Tradition has been thinking about ourselves in these Christian ethics that are dressed in white. And in the white dressing, of course, you are. Other verse about make me as white as snow. And
Yes,
them kind of thoughts in the
though your
people brain.
sins be as scarlet,
Yeah,
the
so.
said blood of Jesus can make you white
Yeah,
as snow.
these type of things they're telling I and I to hold in our meditation. The
Well,
Rastafari said no.
they have done a good job, though, my brother,
Where we're working to under.
amongst Rasta, nay. But
Yeah.
you see, the average man in a Jamaica,
Yes.
almost anything you say to him, say Jesus,
In Jesus' name.
in Jesus'
Hey, you
name.
know something? It really, really grieve. Hey, some youths, 3 youths stop by on the streets today, you know. Yeah, like a drama.
Yes.
You them selling some stuff, you know, and run across the road and say, sir, you want to buy something for me? Some say, what not there? I'm say some big stuff. I say, well, my stuff that so I say, when I sell it for. Them say we're working for the church owner. Some say, me not buy it. The youth them face need to drop on the ground. I say, me not support church, you know. The youth them couldn't believe me, you know. I'm say, me not support Jesus either, you know.
Yes.
You them say, then see no support youths. Me say, yeah, me support you as a youth. Yeah, it's a heavy program.
Very heavy man.
Very heavy program. And we're working to deprogram the program.
It is not good to travel today, neither to cross the ocean. Deserts are dry, water thirsty. Too good to travel today, neither to cross the ocean. Deserts so dry, water thirst kill you. Kill you, kill you, kill you. Kill you, kill you. When it waited to create, when it down the ground so very, don't want to see you on the ground. Don't want to see you on the ground. The ground, the ground, the ground. Caution, my brother, caution, baby. Black soul, you black as day. So black. Two more.
Yeah. The sound of the burning spear. A lot of us have short memory. Can't remember how long we have been black. But it's our great father, father, great grandfather, father, 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 mother, mother, great grandfather, father was black.
Black already.
So once the black is there, if you don't have to black again, you can't black again, you black already. So who no black, you know? You better get controls. Because it's a long time blackness around, you know. The Rastaman has been trying to be the leading edge for the resurrection of our blackness. So, for example, now, the whole notion of race again. People in Jamaica have been encouraged to ignore race and think about class. And it's a very deceptive way of holding your consciousness, because you're living in an illusion. You're actually living in denial that there are racist forces in operation. The Rastaman speaks about race, and maybe the only black person in Jamaica who keeps race at the front. I mean, that's why Rastaman run up in so much problems. It's not so much even Selassie yet, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's the whole consciousness of being an African. That the Christian, now, who we call the Barlid, the black Christian Jamaican, who I and I call the Barlid, feels offended that I and I insisting that I is African. But that will continue, Makonnen, because if we surrender that identity, what will we be?
We'll be on the way to heaven.
Oh. So I am misbehaving by not wanting to go to heaven.
Well, because you see, for the Christian, that is the highest possible goal. The epitome of achievement, dead and gone to heaven in Jesus' name.
Wow, Makoni, that sounds scary, my brethren.
But remember, I said the people are not really, like, outwardly confess the fear. But see how much of them, like when you check them, see how much of them ready for dead tomorrow. For kind of hurry home to heaven.
So that's supposed to cause some kind of psychological problem, though, you know. That you want to get somewhere in a hurry, but you're trying to not get there in a hurry.
That
sounds like a conflict in something in the mind, in the brain, Rasta.
Well, look here. You see, because is the said Christianity that find the solution to that particular dilemma.
Also,
well, through the said same Jesus, I saved them. Like the Jesus can save them from anything, you know.
Everything too.
Everything. So mostly now, when them come up on the problem that you have announced here, them simply call upon the name of the said dead white God. And then the said dead white God, please remember that these are not my thoughts on the subject. This is what the Bible said.
Mm-hmm.
For them kill him.
Mm-hmm.
It is not I, Rasta, who kill him. And them said one set up on him and murder him. And then now, after them murder him, him save them. That is the concept.
You think so if the Christian then was to begin to engage with the God of Kali, you think maybe Jesus would have probably just get blown away.
Well, watch out. They would have difficulty at work with the God of Kali.
Yeah.
In the same way, they have difficulty at work with Diana, you know.
Yes.
Because members are like the man them who devoted to Kali.
Yeah.
The man, they are ganja smoking dreadlocks, man, same way over in India, you know.
But you know, say, even the Christian Bible tell you, say, Moses was a ganja smoker.
I, well, to tell you the truth, Rasta, I never knew of that.
Well, I hear, so when he went on the mountain and got engaged and started to burn some bush and some visions come to him, I think he broke upon Kali.
So, it kind of sounded that way to I, Rasta.
So, I broke upon.
It was burning bush.
Yeah, that's a serious thing, you know.
Yes.
A serious thing. And it's all about, you see, a lot of people don't understand now, even the meditations of herb smoking. and the internal movements of consciousness. That the journey is an internal journey when you smoke herb. In other words, no, your consciousness does move, you know. Because consciousness is energy and it's not stationary. But it doesn't move outside. It doesn't move outside, out into the outer world in pursuit of anything. The energy turns inward. And that's what I think the Roman society and what we call Babylon is afraid of. Because when a man's energy turns internally, he becomes more subdued in terms of him quietness. And maybe you can't predict him behavior because he's thinking. So, when I say herb smoking, there's a direct relationship between smoking the kali and your powers of thinking.
True.
What did I say?
Well, it is true. It is very true because if you consider the use of the kali weed, the said ganja plant, among the holy men of India, these are the men who study the culture, the history, the religion. They are the ones who become the philosophers of the total package that the Indians call Hinduism.
Mm-hmm.
So culturally, it is used to expand the mind. Now, which other people presently need mind expansion, need to enter into areas including thinking, redesigning, recreating?
Who needs it more right now?
Than I and I, the black man.
But guess what happened now, brethren?
Yes,
I man thinks that I and I, the black man, engaging in this thing, but for the wrong purposes. In other words, now, in the ancients, you have dealing with the kali. It was never about trying to get high. No man never try to get high. We think man did try to get deep.
See?
Yeah, it was not about a man trying to get out of himself. Do he a drunkard and a whiner would get out of himself and can't remember what him say or do.
See?
The kali man became what we call introspective. Became thoughtful. And it is a brain that is really awakened now through these herbs. I understand that in South Africa, you know, when the fight was on against apartheid, you know, it's just herbs, the man, the gorilla fighter that they use along with the reggae music, the whole of meditation, you know.
See?
The fight of this scourge called racism and violence, you know. So, we're saying to the listeners now, there are potent forces in the cannabis. And the ancients were chemists. Not just philosophers and psychologists and spiritual men. The man was chemists. So the man knew about the properties and how the properties of the cannabis affect the brain cells. So what we want to say to the item now, you see, with more information, it will remove a whole heap of the mystique around this plant. You know, that is, this plant could have been in the Christian Bible that spoke about the tree with the knowledge of good and evil.
Yes, A long time
I try to find out which tree is that, you know, in the Christian Bible, you know.
See.
That in this Garden of Eden, and people remember now, you know, it's the same Bible where the one of them said the truth, you know. It said about a garden, and in the garden there were trees. So we know about plants, that the Almighty planted all these plants. But it seemed to be a special plant that the Almighty put into the earth.
Mm-hmm.
A very, very special plant. So they say it is the most versatile plant on the planet. This plant is like a brother and a sister to the black people. This plant provides everything. We mean everything. Food, medicine, shelter.
Culture.
One plant.
Yes, I.
Cannabis.
It opened a door to possibilities that otherwise would not otherwise exist for the black man. Watch I. You see, without the ganja plant, many mans would never have been able to transition from bald head to Rasta. It's very simple, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It is the use of the ganja that translate in his mentality into being free for the first time. Mm. Now to be able to think his way out of the control of Babylon.
Yes, I.
Out of the vice grip where them have power. So what you're going to find, you know, is all the people who have ever felt moved by the movement of Rasta, is that them responding to? Because Jamaica itself, separate and apart from Rastafari culture, have them own a ganja culture, you know, my brethren.
Mm.
Yes, a ganja culture is there that that don't have nothing to do with I and I.
Mm.
It just dead. More man there so right now a smoke ganja that is barred. And police too.
And soldier.
And soldier.
And lawyers and doctors.
Selassie I the first.
It is right through.
Right throughout the culture.
Culture.
You know, so it don't matter which street you go upon. It don't matter which community.
Mm-hmm.
Because even the politician them smoke it. I man not talk about politician from long time.
Yeah, man.
I talk about the politician right now.
Well, you know, so Winston Churchill used to have a big ganja cigar in his mouth.
All the time?
All the time. Rastafari. Yeah, it's serious.
This is Styles FM. For the best quality in sound reinforcement and backlining, Native Audio. We have professional engineers with over 20 years of experience. So call us and we'll take care of your parties, wedding receptions, barbecues, conferences, and small stage shows. Crystal clear sound, Native Audio. Our prices are the best. Call us at 871-5212. That's 871-5212. Native Audio. We make your events audible.
It's time to rock. We're gonna be rocking Jamaican radio like there's never been rocked before. Now it's 6.1 on your FM, man. Styles FM. Don't you miss it. Saturday morning from 9 o'clock until 1 on the PM. Yours truly, Colin Anthony, the man with all the money on it. Takes the way with the music. Yes, yeah, Styles Trivia, news, features, and much more. We've got it in store. Don't you miss it. Every Saturday morning, live on Styles 96.1, the People's Station. We've got a plan. You've got a plan. Colin Anthony.
Planning a party, club night out, stage show, a gospel concert, or even a business sales event? Let Styles FM be a part of your promoting tool. Take advantage of our low-priced promotion packages with commercials, interviews, giveaways, reviews, and much more. We have special offers when you mix and match and bundle your options. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Styles FM, for the most effective way to exploit your marketing dollar.
With Styles FM on the go, you can listen to your favorite programs by calling the USA number 213-992-4360. If you're in the UK, it's 033-0010-3322.
also my sister too, for a drink of wine so they could drink and be merry, so they could drink and be merry.
Metamorphosis continuing. Dr. Iman Blak, here your host, in studio with Virgin Ross, Ule Tafari, Makunen. Always looking into the things and trying to provide new perspectives for people to sort of engage the brain in some activity. The brain is a very powerful and mighty organ. You know, so Makunen, of late, you know, when I started college in the 70s, you know, my second course of psychology, a professor brother come in one morning, you know, and him said, I tell you something about behavior, various types of behavior, what were normal and abnormal, and all the various causes for abnormal behavior. And at the end of the lecture, you know, the brother look at the class and say, well, of course, you all have a mind, don't you? And everybody say, of course. I'm saying, so, where is it? And the man just hold the class in total silence.
For him to leave same time?
Yeah, he must step out, you know.
Rotted.
And so he must step out.
Yes.
Leave out with a question that I have been pursuing for about 30 years. Yes. Where is the mind, you know? Because, you see, as a youth, I hear about mind, you know, all the while. So you use your mind and man, you lose your mind and don't make nobody interfere with your mind. And you know, the mind talk about. It always sounded like something was surround me. Because I couldn't really see it, if you know what I mean.
See.
So in all of my journeys now into academia and real world and so forth and so forth, I've been searching, trying to locate the mind. The same way we can locate our heart in our chest.
See.
And the same way we can locate our kidneys and our eyes and all our other organs. Where would I locate this thing called mind? Because them say you have to emancipate that if you want free. How would I go about that?
Well, what I know, the mind is an abstraction.
What kind of word that, brother? What that mean?
Like it's a movement away from the reality. Are the same brain, man.
Well, I know. Are you brain or are you mind?
No, I show the man.
All right.
It is the mind, mm-hmm, that is the abstraction. The movement away from the real thing.
Mm-hmm.
Because you see, the European couldn't understand the brain. Really and truly is a difficult thing to understand, you know?
All right.
It's a natural thing. And in a few mechanism to deal with it, in did have to create now an extension of it,
mm-hmm,
the abstraction called the mind.
All right.
So now him attach certain untouchable things to it. Inside of the mind, them things they resign.
you know, to say, it's a thing where I don't think we spend enough time exploring, you know. Because along with this concept of the mind, when a person said, they say, somebody can do you something in your mind and you don't know. Oh, that didn't work.
No, look here now. The thing about the mind, you know, like I man tell you, is an abstraction, an addition,
yeah,
in order to accommodate those things where, like, you couldn't understand it on a brain level. It's like the mysteries of the European world are in your mind. Because this of them place it not in your brain.
Not in your brain.
No. It's, but it's a whole slew of things, you know.
Yeah, yes.
Including Jesus.
Yeah.
As long as them have your mind, you're done.
Yeah, but what is it? You see, that's what I'm trying to put my finger on. When you say them have your mind, them have the abstraction of your brain. Yeah. Wait, what do I mean?
Watch out.
Yeah.
To the how the white man set the mind.
Yeah.
It is the abstraction that now subsume the said brain, put it in an inferior position.
Okay.
Because it is now the mind.
Yeah.
That is doing everything.
Rather than the brain.
Than the brain. It's like, say, the brain coming like one little small thing should be in one corner. I can't hold the mind now. Take over. Because it's a takeover business.
True. But you know, so they're taking over now, them claims that we have to emancipate that thing, we have to take over.
<You're right. laughs> it's difficult.
How is that going to work?
Better you stay with the brain, my brethren.
So what we have to do now within our own reasoning now, that as Rastafari, we have to begin to speak more out of brain matters.
Definitely, man.
And things of the mind, we have to begin to re-examine what really is this mind. Because what the Europeans have constructed now, you know, this mind of three levels, you know. It's a three-story mind, you know. Yeah, I know that.
Watch out.
There's a basement in it too, you know.
Before they go in there.
Yeah.
They talk of it before, you know.
Then?
Yes, I. When the, you see the mind?
Yeah.
I man can't tell you.
Mine are yours. Hold on.
No, it's the Bible.
Oh, the
Bible. The Bible. It's the mind that.
And the mind that?
Yes, Rasta. The Bible is the mind.
So are you justify that?
Well,
by that argument.
It is really very simple, you know.
Yeah.
You see, once the black man take the Bible,
yeah,
him don't need no brain again.
So they say, I'm sorry, no.
he don't need no brain because the book they are the thinking and everything for him.
So we have discovered the mind.
Silas.
You got to know who you are. You got to know what you're for. Black am I, why should I stray? My roots and my culture are so me a go stay. Black am I, like who must I say? Martin Luther King or Marcus Garvey? Black am I, why should I stray? My roots and my culture are so me a go stay. Black am I, like who must I say? Martin Luther King or Marcus? Here some fun dance out there who are really love money gets and that's for sure. We never had enough and so they fight for more. They keep on voting on the freedom door. Just not the same since they came. Black integrity and they stood for the name. Arrive at the aim though they never got the fame. Afterwards it came. Black am I, why should I stray? My roots and my culture are so me a go stay. Black am I, like who must I say? You see him what ready to be the other day. Black am I, why should I stray? My roots and my culture are so me a go stay. Black am I, like who must I say? Try to get the full of go when it come back same way. Yo, hold your ground and wear no frown. Surely we'll be here when that trumpet sound. Yo, keep that faith, don't you ever hate. Blessed is the meek, the reward is great. Hail King Selassie and Lord that he is trained. Earth is the fullness of which he created. He's a
of course, the metamorphosis goes on and we're healing all of our listeners, of course, those who are near and those who are far. Healing the people right here in Port Antonio, right here in Bumbrook, over in Shotover. We say my love the name there, say Shotover. Yeah, man. I man tell me, say, on a very clear night, you can stay from Shotover and look right into Cuba, you know.
Oh.
Yeah, man. That man show I man who, Rasta man who live a long time.
See.
When I want to call him name and him tell him to say, I don't know what I'm saying. But that me take me overstand, you know. And of course, out in St. Thomas, up in Golden Grove, my brethren, Cyril. And of course, over there in Harborview, Ray and Peter Ray and the man them in the Dewey campus and the people in St. Catherine and right across this land of indiscrimination, injustice, and the land of wood and lick a bit of water around through the pipes now. But we give thanks for the sunshine and the cool breeze and the reasoning that we're allowed to hold to this powerful station called Stars FM. They call it freedom of speech. But we hear that if you speak against certain groups, you're no longer free. You know, one time, this group of people called the gays and the lesbians and these J-flag people, one time they were a minor entity in the societies. Now they have arranged themselves to be power brokers. They have now declared that their sexual orientation is a human right. Rastafari for decades have been clamoring for human rights. We have been rejected by the state and certain societies that we have no rights. But here come the gays. And they have rights. So yes, sir, it is more rightful for them to behave in that non-natural way than for Rastafari to continue to contribute to the society. Something wrong, Makonnen. Something wrong.
Watch out.
Something don't right.
No matter how much noise them make, man, them still is a minority. A very minor minority. I make enough noise.
Well, Anna, man.
Don't change it, say them is a minority.
Hey, them have plenty. Hey, you know, the groups rally around the world where they for the games. Remember the games in a Soviet Union, the Olympics? And the man them said them don't want no same sex people, that's up. It's whole heap of countries rally around the protest against the Soviet Union, you know, and Putin tell them to go away. Makonnen, is plenty of them.
I man not say it's not plenty, but it's minority. Minority plenty.
All right.
It's little of them,
so
man.
So we're feeling the tyranny of the minority. You ever hear that concept there?
Yeah, man. Them just talk. Them a talk. You see man and woman.
What you mean them a talk? And them get a man fired and make some artists lose car, concert and money. Rest of man. I know just talk that.
Mostly it's nice, my brethren.
Eh?
Because right you know, we're still one firing we hear about.
But Bunji Bantan and the artists, them lose millions for enough months when them say they're not getting no more concert.
Bunji Bantan get about 15 years.
No, but we
said that statement.
Yeah, so I said to them, I know, them powerful then.
Look here.
Oh, you call it just talk.
For them, power is dear.
Yeah.
But it will never reach the point where them become the majority. You see, even the professor.
Yeah.
Watch I know. You see, I and I have a trad in such a manner that we have to really be careful. The university itself, you know.
Yeah.
I wouldn't the first time the university is in the position where them eschew that kind of dynamics. There was a time when the leadership of the university, it is rumored.
No, it's only rumor, so we can't know whether it's true.
Well, I man still declare it.
Is that a rumor?
Yes.
No, we're not spreading no rumors.
I know I'm not going to talk of it, Rasta. I just declare it.
See?
I don't, you know, I now right, go no right, further. All right, all but right. What I man say, the university long time was in a position to back off them thing there and never do it.
Right.
So now when it reached the point where them themselves take the action.
Come on, where they expose themselves?
Simply a matter of opening the closet door, man.
Well, that's the point I'm making now.
Yes.
You don't realize that all the doors are opening now, Bridging. That is the critical thing now, you know. Them opening the door. Remember, say, what was it before? They were in closets, you know.
Yes.
Now, the NFL, which is American football, and the site of manhood. Yeah, you hear me?
Yeah, man, because the man there is the Warriors now.
And they have now accepted their first gay player. Drafted, openly gay, and then put on a kiss on their boyfriend.
What is this, man?
Right in front of the public, and I'm telling the eye them, say, it's not just talk that. The people, them expressing themselves in a way that even heterosexual seems to be on the retreat.
Watch out, my brethren.
Rastafari, better stand up.
You see where them man they are going with now? Come on, man. You know, remember certain Roman show with the Roman general and Caesar and the man there.
Caesar man.
Them in some lovely garments and them eat grape. And
looking feminist.
Watch I know, Rasta.
Yes, sir.
Them man, they did worse than them man, yeah. Like the new Rome.
All right.
The European
yes.
culture.
Yeah. It a reemerge.
When
yeah.
Rome was the culture. That yes, is that, that was, them used that was to go on with. That was the god of it.
True.
Member
True.
Say, you know, it is rumored in history that is that same malice
yeah.
that destroyed Rome.
Right, right.
Because you see, when the man no longer realized that him is the man and him start to focus in a different direction, who tell the people that the civilization going to survive?
Yeah, it will begin to crumble.
It must begin
must
to crumble.
Crumble.
So you see, the moment we start to talk about homosexuality
mm-hmm.
As the primary
yes.
you know, level.
Is it the same that?
No. The then
decadence that is death.
The problem is, it would only be a while before the implosion. Remember, you know, the woman can only take too much and no more.
Mm-hmm.
For it's to her that we have to give the credence and the praise for the survival of the race.
But it appears as though the female, who ought to be the center of creation and creativity, is being disfigured in this new format that they're trying to present to I and I as a way of going forward. Because look at it this way, Marconin. Can you think of a society that is progressive, that lacks female energy? It kind of sound away, you know, because maybe out of my genetic historical makeup, we just can't be functional without the female. So how is it now that these groups of people now trying to define this lifestyle, which is anti-life, right? This progression, it stopped the progression, you know. It stopped the progression of creativity. What am I really trying to prove? And where is Lord God now?
While all this is going on. Remember, you know.
Overlooking?
Please remember, my brother, we are in the midst of a continuation of the reality that this is European culture. This behavior is standard and normal within European culture. Them man they over is it, you know.
Easy.
Yes.
Yeah.
We never come here with it.
A serious thing.
We arrive here yeah. and observe
mm-hmm.
those of us who took on all of the trappings of Europe. Some of us at that time fell victim. That is one of the trappings. This is European history. The stream that we're going down is the European historical stream.
It's not pretty.
That the homosexual situation should now rise its head again is normal. Ask any one of them. Watch how quick them turn it into legal domain. Canada legalize it. Quite a few states in America legalize it. It done it legal long in Sweden. Long time. And in quite a few ports in Europe, it's the same thing. It's I and I, you know, the black people looking on out of the black perspective and the memory
and
of the skin.
Strange
who see it strange and who saying, because remember, you know, all of them bugrillas and them thing there. The band them a laugh after yeah, we because yeah. them say, nowhere in the normal civilized world do we have laws like that. It's what don't want to mad. But so far, nobody no repeal it yet in the Caribbean.
The question
is, how much longer will we be able to retain our sanity in the face of what is not a real threat?
You know how much longer? When the dollar reached about 150, we will surrender. I am tying our economic decline to the acceptance of this gay life. I think it is proportional to the stress we're feeling.
Yes.
And the more we look out, the more then we lower the dollar.
Uh-huh.
And we suppose we reach a point where we say, well, can't take it no more.
And just knock you over the head.
Yes, and then now the boats will come in with all of these people and with them behavior.
Uh-huh.
Hey, but you see, when them come, you're going to have a set of people on your name, Rastafari. They may have to deal with them people still. That means
Rastafari. We'll be right back.
trouble, here comes the danger. Welcome the savior, welcome the rascal. I and I start the crew, so that's the Selassie army. Here comes trouble, here comes the danger. Sent by the savior, welcome the rascal. You're not the artist who I the general issue in a warning. The people them my ball said them tired of mediocre. Evil like a fall when we're studying at Ethiopia. Leaving from down cause them life not easy but even one chance say it's not an easy book. Operation occupy the motherland. Calling on souls as a kindly to the land. From creation he writing on top. Chronics can't do it alone. So I'm recruiting. So
from Babylon. Cause are you corrupt, you get a youth. We don't know wicked act, we know Babylon. When me walk, I trample down Babylon.
Yeah, this is the generation that is coming forward now, chanting down Babylon. Nah, give room no chance, you know. As much as the opposition rise in all forms of ways, sexual and political and religious, we not take certain chat from Babylon. Because Rome is Rome. And this is the empire that has been oppressing the black people for 2,000 years and more. The Roman Empire. It has changed its looks and its methodologies, but its ideology remains the same. White supremacy. And Rastafari, you know, Sir Makonnen, His Majesty, Lego a speech in the United Nations that Robert Marley take the lyrics and put to song.
Yes, sir.
And a lot of people say it around the world, you know. Them say it over and over in recitation. But you know the first few lines, eh? It say, until the philosophy that holds one race superior to another is finally and permanently discredited and abandoned, then there will always be war.
Sure.
The philosophy that holds one race superior over another. The philosophy of white supremacy. Haile Selassie licking out in the strongest terms against racism and white supremacy. So how can Rastafari hold any other position?
To Bob Marley and the little berry sound sweet. Who no can contact Mama Africa from we again. Who no think who no can contact Mama Africa from we again. No who no can contact Mama Africa from we again. Who no think who no can contact Mama Africa from we again. So the bingy man a call Angola. Call Angola, upon Mama Africa, Angola.
Yeah, Metamorphosis continuing in pseudo Ras Makonnen, and we're just exploring consistently the essence of our own being, the sides of ourselves that have been confused, and try to clear up some of the deception, because deception and confusion, you know, are two of the mighty forces that are promoted by white supremacy. Confuse you and deceive you in store.